Feminist Creativas presents a word for every generation that knows no fashion.
Greetings. I hope and trust I find you well. We have one more mountain experience as we start our working week. And our devotional is titled, The War in Your House. Come with me to the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17. The verse is 1. And let us read up to verse number 3. Now the Philistines gathered together their armies to battle and were gathered together in Shokok, which belongeth to Judah, and pitched between Shokok and Azekah in Ephes-Damim. And Saul and the men of Israel were gathered together and pitched by the valley of Elah, and set the battle in array against the Philistines. And the Philistines stood on the mountain on one side, and the Israelites stood on the mountain on the other side, and there was a valley in between them. May the good Lord bless the reading of His word as we spend a moment in prayer. Let us pray, my dear friends. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, we are under attack. The evil one has set up camp in our territories. He has set up camp in our homes, camp in our companies. As the working week begins, how we pray, dear Lord, that through this lesson we may know that we need to trust you. You have a plan that will work for us only as we lean upon your provisions. This has been our prayer of faith. Bless one and all in Jesus' name, we pray and ask, amen. My good friends, allow me to raise, as usual, 5 points before we go our separate ways. What we find herein is an issue where the Philistines have attacked the children of Israel. The Philistines have not only attacked them, they have invaded their territory. And I want to talk to someone this morning. You know there is someone who has made it their mission to attack you. They have not only made it known, but they have even moved physically into a space that belongs to you. They have literally taken over. This is what the Philistines have done. They have moved into the territory of Judah, known as Shokok. Right there in Shokok, they have set up camp. And these are not only enemies, but they are the arrogant type. An arrogant type of an enemy is one enemy of a kind. I mean the one who moves into your office, the one who moves into your house, the one who moves into your flat, the one who moves onto your workstations, your working desk, and takes over. There are people like that at work. And as you're about to go out, I'm saying, listen, my friend, you are going to meet a Philistine. There is a Philistine out there, and this Philistine is not only an ordinary person, but it is someone who, when they stand up, the odds are against you. At point number two, notice this. When the Bible begins at verse number one, it says, now the Philistines gathered together their armies. Armies, men of war. Now listen to verse number two. How does it read? And Saul and the men of Israel. The men of Israel are not referred to as an army, but they are distinguished by gender. They are distinguished by sex. They are just men. But as far as the Philistines are concerned, they are an army. They are disciplined. They are well-trained. They are not only well-trained, they are men of war. And you are facing an adversary who outnumbers you, an adversary who has more experience than you do, an adversary who has more tactics than you have. Such is the space of work. These are people who are at a vantage position. They do not just come and attack Israel, but they are in Shokok and they camp on a mountaintop. Where do the men of Israel camp? Go on and read verse number two. And pitched by the valley of Elah. They cannot even be confident in their own space, in their own home, in their own backyard. They have to hide in some valley. But the Philistines announce their presence and they camp on the mountaintop so that it can be known. They have not only moved in, but they have taken over. And you are nowhere to be seen. Such is the pain of life, and some of us may be going through this. Go to verse number 8, as if that is not enough. They send out Goliath. You know him. The man had 6 fingers on one hand, 6 on the other hand, and we are told his helmet and his shield weighed about 125 pounds. The man was 9 feet tall. And then he steps out and he says, if you guys are ready to fight, this is what I am about to tell you. Listen to verse number 8. He stood and shouted to the Israelite battle formations, why do you come out to line up in battle formation? He asked them, am I not a Philistine? And are you not servants of Saul? Choose one of your men and have him come down against me. These are the types of enemies that mock your strategy. When you are seeking a comeback, they laugh at you and say, how dare you? Why all these people? All just to respond to one man? Are you guys serious? Just choose one person. And they go on not only to deride the strategy, but to even call out on your leader. Are you not servants of Saul? Choose one man. And obviously, if there is a man who cannot be taken by the lower ranking soldiers, who cannot be taken by the army general, logic follows he must be taken by the leader. And Saul is a no-show. And this Philistine asks, are you not going to send out one man, a representative? If I floor this man, you will serve us for the rest of your lives. And if you victor over me, the Philistines are going to serve you for the rest of your lives. Listen to verse number 11, where the leaders are a no-show. When it is time for them to step up, be seen and counted, leaders have a tendency of disappearing. Fear cripples from the top to the bottom, resulting in not only a crisis, but a paralysis. Verse 11 says, when Saul and all Israel heard these words from the Philistine, they lost their courage and were terrified. Fear robs us both of leaders and followers. If we are equally afraid, no one has a right to stand up and call themselves a leader. Those who are in leadership must inspire confidence in the followers. But Saul and the leaders of the day, the army generals, Saul and the men of Israel of the day were terrified. They were shivering. They were shaking in their boots. Why? Because an enemy had set up camp right where they were. But I love the way the Lord works. The Lord always has a solution to our problems. But many a time, those solutions do not lie close to us. God shall present one with an opportune solution, and he shall present you, my friend, with an opportune solution, and it won't be long. I will ask you to trust me on this one. Just hold on. Just hold on. Do not give up as you go through this week. Remember, the children of Israel are yet to sit it out for 40 days. 40 days while they're waiting for David to come in. Wait for your David. He will definitely come. For verse 12 ends with these words. Now, David was the son of the Ephraimite from Bethlehem of Judah, named Jesse. Your David is coming, my friend. It won't be long. Allow me to ask you and to challenge you. Hold on until you meet again next Monday when David shall walk in. For now, when the enemy sets camp, let him enjoy. 40 days will expire and David is coming. Until you meet again, blessings and peace.